Hi everyone, this is Josh from Unito. Today I'm going to show you how to sync Asana tasks and milestones with events in Google Calendar. As you can see here, I have my Asana project on the left and a Google Calendar on the right. And there are three events here that are all synced with tasks or milestones here in my Asana project. This one here, Conference 2022, is the same as this event right here. They're in a two-way sync that connects all sorts of details. They're considered mappable fields by Unito. So I have the name of the event or the milestone, the time as well. So I've got the date range and time here. The description syncs also. Any attachments you want to add can appear here. And these are just some of the different fields that you can sync between your tasks or milestones and events in Google Calendar. So let me take you into the Unito Flow Builder and I'll show you what it looks like. So the first thing you'll have to do is go through a five-step process to connect your tools. So here, I have an unfinished flow that I'm going to build as we go, and I'll show you what the finished version looks like for the sync that I've just shown you. So the first thing you'll need to do is connect your tools through this drop-down menu. So you'll just have to put Asana on one side, Google Calendar on the other. The order doesn't matter because you'll set a flow direction in the next step. The first time you set up your tools, you'll need to go through an authorization process to give Unito permission to access the specific data in each tool that you'd like to sync in a bidirectional flow. So I'll just show you the completed one over here while I get this one set up on the left. You just have to choose your account for the specific calendar and project you'd like to sync. So I connected a demo account for this calendar. And then once that loads, you have to specify the exact project in Asana and the exact calendar in Google Calendar that you'd like to sync together. So I had event planning with my upcoming events calendar. And if you have multiple projects you'd like to sync with one calendar, or multiple calendars that you'd like to sync to from a single project, you'll have to create different flows for each connection that you'd like to create. But there's a very easy way to duplicate them through our Help Center. You can find that. So there we go. That's event planning with upcoming events. So they're already synced together. That's what this warning is telling me because I've created this flow already. But for the sake of our demo, we can just ignore that. The next thing you'll do is set up a flow direction. So what we mean by that is at this stage of your flow creation process, you have to tell Unito whether you'd like to create new Google Calendar events automatically or new Asana tasks automatically. In this case, we're sending data from Asana into Google Calendar, so we've chosen a one-way sync. But as you'll see, any events that are created based on your Asana tasks or milestones will still be in a two-way sync at the field mapping stage, which we'll explain in a moment. First, we have to set up our rules. So rules determine how to filter out tasks or milestones that aren't relevant for your calendar. And an easy way to do that is to apply tags in Asana. So I've added tags to all of my tasks and milestones. In this case, I've added some tags under the location field, and I've called them local and out of town to keep things simple. Another field I've added tags to is the responsible department. So in this case, we might imagine an events team that is managing a certain event that would then appear in Google Calendar. There's events. And so now the set of instructions here in Unito tells us that if a task is created in Asana in this particular project and the status is open, meaning it has not been completed, and the creation date is on or after today's date, and there's a tag, local or out of town, or events in responsible department, it will automatically create an event in Google Calendar based on those parameters. Later on, you'll be able to tell Unito to apply these rules to all of your historical tasks and milestones in that project if you so choose. And we'll explain that later on. First, we're going to set up our field mappings. So if I select Automap, Unito will try to guess which fields in Asana should be paired up with fields in Google Calendar. And as we can see here, it's pretty good. It knows that the assignees in Asana could be the guests in Google Calendar. We'll leave that one as is. Start date and time match up. The description for each. The due date matches with the end date and time. Description footer means that anything in the other column will then appear in the footer of that task or milestone. Same for the URL. And in reverse from Asana to Google Calendar. So if you're happy with those settings, you can just hit confirm. Thank you, Automap. And then you would just hit launch flow. And you would see events just like this pop up in Google Calendar. One last trick I'll point out. In the rules section, you have a condition that's preset, the creation date on or after today's date. If you remove that, it will sync all tasks and milestones in Asana that match the parameters of your rules into Google Calendar. So this condition here is a safeguard to prevent that from happening until you're happy with the flow. You may decide that you don't want to sync all of your previous out-of-town or local events or whatever your tags may be. You may not want to sync all of your historical tasks associated with the events department, whatever your tags may be. So this allows you to refine it once you understand how the flow works and how your data will sync between tools. And that's it. Thanks for watching.